everybody, welcome today to Magnolia Outdoors. I'm Katie Waldrep, and this is my friend Carmen Johnston.
Hey, Katie.
And she is a garden expert. So I thank you for coming today, and she's just gonna show us about how to do some containers and mantles and for the cold weather. So
yes.
Thank you, Carmen.
Well, Katie, I'm so glad to be here. It's such a beautiful place, and she's got some beautiful things to work with today. We're going to show you how to get your containers ready for winter. And there are a few things that I thought that everybody should have, and a few staples. So one of my secret formulas is called the three T's. You need something tall, thick, and trailing when you're planting a container garden. So I've got two different containers here, and I thought I would show you. And some, Katie, you know you have some of my favorite colors here.
Good.
I love turquoise, and I love cobalt blue, especially in the wintertime, because it's really hard to kind of find some different colors and stuff. Mm-hmm. And so Katie went, I asked her, I said, can you get some good soil? So you found some good soil at the local hardware store.
Yes.
And I think it's Black Cow.
Mm-hmm.
So you always want to make sure that you start your container gardens with a really good potting soil. Don't skimp on it. Don't go cheap.
Okay.
And also make sure your containers have good drainage. If they don't have good drainage, then your plants are going to drown.
So what do you do if they don't have?
You want to make sure that you drill a hole in the bottom of the container.
Okay.
So, but if it's ceramic, sometimes it's a little bit harder to drill a hole. So try to always buy a container that has a hole in it. If not, drill it and you'll be good to go. Another secret, in the wintertime, you know, you don't need as much soil. So what we did is we filled these up halfway with mulch.
Okay.
And you can use pine bark, pine cones, anything that you have in your yard. Sometimes people use packing peanuts.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it makes the container lighter. So fill up your container halfway with mulch or bark or anything lightweight. Then fill the rest of it with soil. And you always want to make sure that you leave about 2 inches below the top of the container. So then that way when you're planting or when you're watering, the soil doesn't go everywhere.
Okay,
so I've got some of my three T's here. This is called a lemon cypress topiary. Rub it and smell it.
Oh yeah.
I know, doesn't it smell good?
Mm-hmm.
I know, this is a lemon cypress. This goes all year round. It doesn't like the heat. I've taken it through the heat before, but this is a beautiful way to dress up your containers. And this is my something tall. So this is a lemon cypress. Then I've got my something trailing. This is Everillo carex. This is a great grass, and it's something that goes all year round as well. And then this is my something thick, and this is a peacock kale. This gets absolutely stunning. It's absolutely gorgeous in the wintertime, and it will get about this big. So it's absolutely beautiful. Okay, so now let's start planting. Okay, I'm gonna get you to get your hands dirty.
Okay.
So we're gonna take these out of the pot, and we're gonna plant in the shape of a triangle. So if you kinda wanna help me move some soil right back in through there. Thank goodness she told me she had not gotten a manicure done yet. So we're good to go. Okay, then this is our something thick, the Everillo carex, if you just want to make a little home for this. And then we're just going to kind of go right here. We're going to nestle that down. And then I'll plant the kale.
Okay.
And then you've got, I've got to show you this.
Okay.
This is a beautiful, healthy root system. Look at how nice and white that is. When you're buying plants, make sure you've got that nice, healthy root system. This is gonna take off. And I am gonna loosen this up just a touch.
Okay,
so now you've gotten your three T's. Do you remember them? Tall, thick, and trailing.
Tall, thick, and trailing.
Now we're gonna fuss it out with some violas. Now you could be good to go with this because this will fill out nicely. But if you wanna add some zhuzh to it, we're gonna we're gonna zhuzh it up. We're gonna add violas. And Katie, I love to use violas because they fill out so much better than pansies do, but I've got one of my favorite pansies here I'm gonna show you as well.
Okay.
So we're going to nestle these in the little holes. I'm gonna let you plant that one right there.
Do I need to loosen these up a little bit?
Yeah, go ahead and loosen those up just a touch. So we're just planting them in another shape of a triangle. And you know, this is the way that you get that container garden look, that professional look every time. It's just an easy formula. Plant in the shape of a triangle, use your three T's, and you are looking great. So you've got a really good looking container garden.
Wow.
Now, you know my favorite colorway is white and green.
Okay.
I love white and green. It's classic.
It's just classic.
Right. And it's just beautiful. But now we're going to kind of zhuzh it up and come over here a little bit, and we're going to use some purples. So we've got the same mix going on, except I added a few little extras of my favorites. This is also lemon cypress, okay? So I'm going to let you go ahead and plant that. We're going to put that in. Now, lemon cypress will get probably about, it can get about 3 to 4 feet tall, and it is just a great container plant. Next, this is a another peacock kale, except look at that gorgeous purple color. It's so pretty. So I'm going to let you take that out. So this is my something tall, this is my something thick, and then this is Angelina sedum. Now, if you notice here, I have a common theme going on. I'm using a bright green chartreuse color because it always makes everything pop. If you don't use bright chartreuse green, then use like a silver or a gray.
Okay.
So it's a great. Now, we're going to do the same thing, and we're just going to fill in with some purple violas. And I'll let you fill in the holes over there. And we're just going to keep stuffing and shoving. Now, I'm all about instant gratification. I want it to look full and instant immediately.
Right.
So that's why we're just going to stuff and shove.
So you want two in each little hole.
Yeah, just because this is a, yeah, let's go ahead and do two. Because I want it to go ahead and look instant. Because you're having family over for,
for Christmas,
right? Yeah. And then these are great, too. They'll go all year until the, you know, until springtime. And okay. That's when they're really going to start doing their thing. So to keep these looking healthy during the wintertime, you want to use a water-soluble fertilizer. Don't use the kind that you know, that breaks down. You want to use a water-soluble like Miracle-Gro.
Like Miracle-Gro.
Yes. And then you want to make sure these get full sun. They can take a few hours of shade, but these are great containers for the full sun.
And how often do you water these?
I would say water probably at least twice a week. Now, even if it rains, you need to make sure that they still get plenty of water. And especially if we're going to get freezing temperatures, make sure you water them before it gets really cold. Because there's something that happens when it freezes, it pulls out all the moisture and it can really damage the plants. So be sure to water well.
Water them before it gets freezing.
Yes.
The day that it's supposed to freeze that night.
Yes. You want to make sure you water them really well. It kind of gives them a little protective barrier.
Now, should we add more soil to kind of pack them in?
Yeah, we're going to go ahead and stuff and shove a little bit more soil. And then you should be good to go. And you should have some great containers. And these will be perfect for the winter.
Okay.
I know. I think we're good to go. Just finish adding in, and you can see now once it gets hot and once it warms up, these plants will continue to grow all summer long. So you can take out the violas and add in petunias.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's a great, it can be a year-round look. And that's one of the reasons why I love to use shrubs and evergreens in my containers, because you get the most bang for your buck.
Okay.
Well, that's
great.
We've got some great containers for the winter.
This is great. Thank you, Carmen.
You're welcome. And we're going to show you some more coming up next.
Okay.
So now we've got some containers that I want to show you, two different ones. One is how to get them ready for your front porch and for the holidays. And then this is just a great, simple, easy container arrangement that anybody can do. So let's start with this one first.
Okay.
So I was saying earlier that I always like to use a shrub in my containers. So instead of doing the three T's, we're literally going to plop this shrub in the center. And this is just a Japanese boxwood. Something that's simple. It grows all year round. And we're going to create a skirt of flowers around it. Now, I'm going to use, this is my favorite pansy. It's a trailing pansy, meaning that it will trail down and soften the edges. Okay. And it's gorgeous. Of course, I'm using my favorite color palette again, white. And I love to use the blue. So we're just going to plant these around in the shape of a triangle. So I'm going to let you stuff that one over there. Now, again, this is a trailing pansy, and I love it. Wait till, it's kind of looks leggy right now, Katie, but when it does her thing, she's beautiful. She's very pretty. Okay, then in between that, I'm going to stuff with the violas. And let me get some of these violas out. Now, you don't have to, I'm going to plant three pansies and then three violas.
Okay.
And I'm going to loosen up the root systems. And we're just creating a skirt. So if oftentimes, you know, and Katie, you've said this to me before. You're like, oh my gosh, I don't know what to do for my containers. I don't know how to plant them.
Right.
This is an easy arrangement that anybody can do. Just find a shrub that likes the sun. You can never go wrong with boxwoods. Put it in the center. I'll plant this one over here. The Myola. I mean, loosen up the root system. And then create a skirt of flowers. And then in the springtime, remove the pansies and I'll add like petunias or begonias, and you've got a really good look. So let me give you one more viola over here so you can finish
just
it out.
Plant this here.
And then you can shove it in there. And then give it about 2 or 3 weeks and you'll have this gorgeous white skirt all the way around.
Yeah.
That's super easy. A very easy look. And then later we'll just finish adding some different soil, and you want to finish filling it in.
Okay, so you just did three pansies and
three violas and put a shrub in the center. Now, of course, remember, don't forget, always start with the pot. It has good drainage. You want to make sure you use really good soil. This takes full sun. This can take about 2 hours of shade, but you want to make sure that you always keep them watered.
Okay.
Because if you don't water them, they're not going to live.
And these are what is in the ground,
yes,
too, right?
They're great. You know, we did this around, created this at your entryway, and that's why I love to always use shrubs, because I mirror sometimes what I'm doing in my landscape, in the yard, in the garden, also in the containers. Great, easy, fast
easy.
Look. You can do it. I promise.
Easy,
so
right?
So for those people
easy.
Who don't know how to do containers, this is your go-to.
Love easy.
Love it. Okay, next. Now we're really going to step it up a few notches. This is another lemon cypress topiary, except it's shaped in a two-ball topiary. This is a lemon cypress, and we went around the farm and harvested a few things. Now, I wish I could remember the name of this, so for you viewers out there, you let us know what this is. I think it's a type of pyracanthus or something, but I love it because look at the gorgeous red berries.
Right.
So I always, something that's very budget friendly is I try to find something or different things to snip and clip from the garden. And Katie, remember when we planted your garden? I was like, let's make sure we plant things that we can snip and clip from.
Right.
So I'm going to use this and then also some gorgeous magnolia. And when you're cutting your greenery, let it soak overnight in a bucket of water.
In a bucket, okay.
The whole thing does not, you just wanna make sure you've got about 4 inches of water in the bottom of the bucket. Let this soak overnight. It gives them a nice drink so your greenery will last longer.
Okay.
Now we're gonna create a skirt around the cypress topiary. So I'm gonna let you finish plucking off a few things of magnolia for me. And we're literally just gonna shove these directly into the soil. And Katie, what happens is this actually acts like oasis. The soil, the plant will actually pull, just step and shove around, will pull from the moisture of the soil, and it helps keep the greenery looking fresh all season long. So don't be afraid just to step and shove directly into the soil. Yep, there you go, perfect. And you're just gonna wanna remove some of that. Yep, and then we'll let you finish stepping and shoving some of that stuff. Now, as you're finishing that out, we're going to finish adding more magnolia. I'm going to show you another one of my secret weapons.
Okay.
Spray paint.
Spray paint on your plants.
Yes. Well, let me show you. We're actually going to spray paint some of the pine cones.
Okay.
You can spray paint the pine cones. You also could definitely spray paint some of this stuff. And I love to give it a little shot like this. And it gives it just a little touch of glisten. And look at how that makes that look so expensive.
Wow.
And it's very budget friendly. So we're just gonna step and shove. Let's see, where else do I have some? And then you've created a beautiful skirt, Christmas tree skirt.
Wow.
And you're ready to go for the holidays. Now let's just nestle in some pine cones. I'll let you nestle them in over here. And look how easy that was.
Wow.
And you're ready to go for Christmas.
That's wonderful.
You have some beautiful limelight hydrangea blooms. This is also a great thing that you can spray and stuff and shove to your arrangements. It's absolutely gorgeous. It's so pretty. Oftentimes, people
spray
stuff these in their Christmas trees as well. They're great to add on top of wreaths. They're so pretty.
Right.
And just spray paint it. And you are ready to go for
tip.
The holidays. So we just simply created a great skirt around it. You want to make sure that you water this at least twice a week, so this helps give these a nice drink. In the springtime, take out, or in the wintertime, take out your greenery and add the pansies or violas around it, and you've got to look for all season long.
So you're telling me that this is actually going to last?
It'll last at least 4 to 5 weeks because you're watering it.
Okay.
I know. And the soil works like an oasis. Okay. It works great. I know. And see, doesn't that look so pretty?
Wow.
I know. You've got a really pretty look for the holidays. And you can use all kinds of different greenery. Magnolia works great. You could spray the magnolia. I always like to use some sort of texture. Nandina berries work absolutely fabulous, and definitely pine cones. It's something that everybody has in their yards around here. And you just simply spray them and you create a beautiful skirt. So you've got two great looks, your winter look, your holiday look, and I've shown you how to take this out and stuff some pansies or violas afterwards, and you're good to go.
Thank you, Carmen.
You've got a great look. Okay, so now we're going to show the mantle. So be sure to come back.
All right, thank you. Now Carmen's going to show us what to do at the front door.
Okay, so we've got a few tips. Katie, you already had some great containers. So we're just gonna fuss them out a little bit. Real quick, one of the things I wanna show you, with the holidays, everybody loves, we were just talking about cooking in between segments and how much everyone loves to cook and make cocktails. This is a great little tiny container that I love to always have. Sage, rosemary, and thyme makes great Christmas presents, great to keep at your front door, great to always snip and clip from. But those are just the three T's, rosemary, sage, and thyme. I love them. Okay, so with your containers.
Okay.
So you had some gorgeous wreaths on your front door, and I was like, oh my goodness, can we use this? Because this is another way to dress up your pot, is take your wreath, place it directly on top of your pot, and add a lantern on top, and you could stop right there, or, and then it has a real candle in it, and you can find these at, you know, Kohl's, Michael's, they've got all kinds of lanterns, your local hardware store, all kinds of great looks, but we're going to zhuzh it up a little bit. Remember I was showing you earlier how we sprayed the limelight hydrangeas?
Right.
We're simply going to create a skirt around here. So we're just going to tuck these in really tightly, and you can just break them off. And I'm going to let you start on your side. And we've only got about six to work with, but just tuck them in as tight as you possibly can. And we just used our good old-fashioned, there you go, just tuck it right in, our good old-fashioned spray paint. And we sprayed the limelight hydrangeas. So there you go, tuck a one right there. So I think we're just gonna do it in the four corners. Gorgeous. Okay. See, look how easy that is just to dress it up, and it adds a nice little sparkle. Then we're gonna go around and fill in with our pine cones. Okay. So just do it like two pine cones or maybe one in between, and you've got a gorgeous look for the holidays. And look at how easy it was. It did not take us a long time to do. And you just simply place it. Now, if you wanted to really zhuzh it up even more, you could add in some Nandina berries. But look, I love to use gold at Christmas. It's something that's so classic. It's something that's so pretty. So, I mean, look, you've got a great look for the holidays. And it was easy. You could take gold ornaments and fuss them around. If you don't have any hydrangeas, pine cones, you can find pretty much anywhere. But that's a really easy look to dress up your front door and make your guests feel welcome. Because that's the whole point of the holidays. We know I know I'm having a bunch of people over.
Right.
I'm sure you are as well.
I am too, yes.
Santa's coming to our farm.
That's right.
So we're doing all kinds of fun things to get ready for it. But that's a very quick, budget-friendly, easy way to dress up your container. Okay. Another thing is, remember I was telling you about that fabulous company called Schubert's?
Right.
These are these topiaries. These are tall ivy topiaries. They're so grand, and they're absolutely stunning. I know, and it takes them at least 2 years to grow something like this, maybe even a year. It takes a long time.
Wow.
But they're just beautiful, and ivy is something that's so low maintenance and very easy to take care of. But this definitely needs some shade.
Okay.
And we just took it out of the plastic pot and stepped into the pot, and you could also place a wreath around here. You could stuff and shove magnolia around it for the holidays, or I think it's perfectly fine just to leave it as is, whatever you want to do. So these are two great easy ways to dress up your front door, and don't forget, or you can put them on your patio.
Yes.
You know, they're all different kinds of places you can do this. On your deck, on your back porch, at your front door. But like I said, I always like to have pots of herbs everywhere around, because it makes everything smell so fragrant. And I like to snip and clip from them from the kitchen.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And rosemary will last for forever as long as you...
It does. And you know, rosemary grows where strong women live.
That's right.
Yes. So I always have rosemary growing anywhere. You know, we just moved from Columbus back to our farm and I always plant rosemary wherever I live. So yes. We need to get some rosemary in your yard too.
That's right.
For sure. Okay, so we got two great looks.
Okay.
For the holidays. And now next, I think we're going to show you how to do the mantle.
Okay, let's go.
Okay.
Welcome back. Now we're going to talk about how to do our mantle.
Well, we've got a beautiful mantle to work with. It's absolutely stunning and it's got a beautiful, what is that above, Katie? I don't know, but it's gorgeous. It sets the tone for a beautiful mantle. But what I always like to do when we're creating a garland is start with a foundation to work out of. So here we've got a gorgeous magnolia garland that we created on our own. And we just simply took, it's called paddle wire. But okay. We bunched up the magnolia and we wrapped it around and just kept wrapping it and we created a long garland. If you don't want to do that, the easy way is just to buy a fake garland.
Right.
And just use the wire from the fake garland and wire in the different greenery. But we decided to do something a little bit extra and fun today. So we did the magnolia garland. And something I always like to do when all of our greenery before we use it is soak it in a bucket of water overnight. Mm-hmm. That way it can drink. I also like to use, it's called Pristine. It's something, let me spray it, let me show you so you can feel it. It's just this stuff, I'm not sure what's in it. We call it the magic go-go juice. But you just spray it on your greenery and it keeps it feeling.
It helps it.
From getting crispy. All okay. season long. So it's absolutely wonderful. So I spray it on everything. Now, I've never tried to spray it on my Christmas tree before. I just thought about that.
That's what I was going to ask. Like your Christmas tree.
I mean, I guess you could.
On Christmas Eve, it's starting to get kind of crispy.
It's so crispy. So, you can use it in all greenery. I spray it on my wreaths.
Okay.
I put it on anything. And especially when it's not Christmas, I use this for my fresh floral arrangements as well.
Right.
So it works out great. But it's called Pristine. I think you can get it on Amazon.com or Michael. Or your local craft store. So it's something I definitely would make the investment. But usually $5 to $7.
$5.
Yeah, it's okay. Not that expensive. And it only takes about one bottle for the whole entire mantle.
Okay, so
the different greenery that we're gonna layer in today is we've got our Leyland cypress.
Mm-hmm.
We've got, which is just cut fresh from the farm. We've got seeded eucalyptus. Now, this actually is something that doesn't grow around here. Now, here is some eucalyptus. There are some eucalyptus trees that grow, and that will work beautiful. I love that silver tone. But this is something that I just bought at the local grocery store. Try Fresh Market, or your local florist will have this. But as you can see, I started layering the different textures in. And we placed this so it's asymmetrical. So meaning it's a little bit shorter on that side than it is on this side. It just adds a nice little flair and it makes something different and fun. But I layered in the seeded eucalyptus and I wanted it to flow over because I think it adds a nice texture.
Carmen said that was in style right now as being off because I would have centered it.
Well, but. I'm all about symmetry. I love something to be, things to be symmetrical, but it is perfectly fine for it to be a little asymmetrical too sometimes. So we made it a little bit different. So Katie, what I'm gonna get you to do is just start layering in some of that Leyland cypress and tuck it underneath. And as you're doing that, I'm just simply gonna stuff some of the seeded eucalyptus on the sides. Now, I don't know about you, but you know, you've got three children, Katie, and you're always on the go. And so this is one, that's perfect. So you're just gonna come all the way and just kind of place it randomly. This is one of those garlands that does not take long to do. And don't get worried about, oh my goodness, am I placing something in the right place? Or
Just
do it. It's gonna look beautiful because we're all so busy now and we don't really have a lot of time on our hands, but we want everything to look nice and pretty
for
the holidays. So I know some of our favorite Christmas traditions are, I'm always doing this at the last minute at my house.
Mm-hmm.
And it's always, I'm sending my husband out on the farm to go and get fresh greenery right before the season starts and just trying to get everything done. But one of the things is that pristine also helps when you've got a fire going from getting crispy. But let me tell you what, be careful.
Okay. Because we've caught some things on fire before, mm-hmm. and you know about that.
Well, I do know about that.
So you've got to be careful that you want to make sure. But look at that gorgeous layering what that seeded eucalyptus does. And it just drapes over, and it's so pretty. And I'm going to get you to stuff some.
Put it on the top, too?
Yeah, I'm going to let you go and layer some in up top. There you go, perfect. And layer in some on the other side. And just layer it straight on top of it. And say, look, it's just beautiful. Makes it so simple and easy. Now we're going to, next, this is Cryptomeria. And she's got this growing on her farm. So always when you're planting things, and that's something we did with Katie's mm-hmm. garden, is when we planted, I thought about what could we cut and harvest, you know, for the holiday season.
Right.
And Cryptomeria is definitely one of those things. So you can layer that underneath or on top.
And both of these kind of look like a Christmas tree.
They do, yeah. So it's something that's very traditional. It's very pretty. You just layer it. And this is something you can do inside or outside, and it works great. And don't be afraid to get out the spray paint for this either, because this also works really well with spray paint. You can, it really adds some nice texture to it. So we're just gonna finish the layer. I'm gonna do a big piece right here in the center. But that seed, see, look at how gorgeous.
Ooh, that's good.
See, that seeded eucalyptus.
That's so pretty.
I know. And look, we just stuffed and shoved. I know, it doesn't take
long.
Wow. Let's do one more piece right here. Yeah. I think sometimes some people get intimidated by doing the different, you know, they're like, I can't do that, but you can. Just try
it.
Just try. I think it's a lot like cooking sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes some recipes work, sometimes they don't.
Sometimes we have to toss out the burnt cookies.
Exactly.
But
it's all easy and it works out really well. So we've got gorgeous greenery. You could add some of those sprayed pine cones and add some of those different layers.
Perfect.
Oh yeah, look. So I'm just gonna layer these in there. Now another neat thing that you can do if you really wanna place them are these are different, these are called picks, wire picks. And you can buy these at Michael's, but you can wire your pine cones if you have time. If you don't,
place them up there.
Yeah, I just place them up there. But let me show you this really quick trick. You just simply take this, wrap it around the wire. They're super simple and easy. And you just wrap it. Put it in there, and it kind of helps hold the pine cone
mm-hmm.
in place, and just twist it, and then you can stick in this little tiny pick, and it helps hold it in.
Wow!
Yeah, so it's just a great pick. Or don't be afraid to break out the hot glue gun.
Okay.
Oh yeah, we've been up there, and I mean, we'll have the hot glue gun and putting it and stuffing our pine cones in the right place. But it's just a really fast, easy, gorgeous look. Always try to pick colors. Try not to pick all the greenery that looks the same color.
Okay.
If you notice here, see we've got, that's a big
brown.
Trick. We've got the brown, that gorgeous copper from the magnolia. We've got that gorgeous light chartreuse green from the seeded eucalyptus. And then this gorgeous chartreuse mm-hmm. green. And then that green, and see how those colors really complement very well.
Yes.
And you've got a gorgeous holiday garland that will last you for at least 2 to 3 weeks by using this magic stuff called Pristine. And then also soak your greenery for at least overnight in buckets of water to give it a drink before you start fussing out your mantle.
Well, Carmen, thank you so much for coming. I really appreciate
it. I'm so glad. We loved it. It's always a joy to be out here. And I hope everyone has a great holiday season.
Yes, and thank you so much for watching Magnolia Outdoors.